Welcome guys, today's video I'm going to share with you on paper issues. Firstly, I'm going to share with you on the requirements and what you should be doing to avoid your paper being limited. I know at this time, especially I don't know what's happening, so many papers are being limited. So I'm going to share with you, give you the skills on how to prevent your paper from being limited. And later on this video, I'm going to share on how to remove money from your paper that is on hold. You know, it's very disappointing having money on paper, but you can't withdraw the money. Yeah, I know in this freelancing business there are so many disappointing things maybe, but as for me, a put off or something that is really boring is having money on your paper and you can't withdraw it. I know some may say low seasons and stuff, but yeah, of course currently I guess in low seasons we are not receiving so many jobs, especially in the transcription and captioning sector, but I guess maybe as time goes by we're gonna be okay. Yeah, back to our point. The first thing that you should do is avoid logging to PayPal using a VPN, because you are lying. You see, PayPal is a big company, so each time you try to log in with a VPN, they're gonna detect that you're using a VPN and they're gonna limit your account, or maybe put in on temporary limitation or permanent limitation. And when your PayPal is on temporary limitation, kindly don't just hurry up and upload anything. Make sure the documents that they have asked you to upload, you upload the exact documents, and the documents are in relation to your PayPal. Your names appear the same way as they appear in your document, for example, your DL or your national ID and stuff. Avoid logging into PayPal using different devices. For example, now you use your laptop, different IP. The second time you use your phone, different IP. You use your friend's phone, different IP. Your friend's laptop, different IP. Within a day, you've logged in to more than four devices. That is gonna cause issues to your PayPal, because they're going to detect something. Maybe it's not the same person who's trying to log into PayPal, and then you get yourself being asked some notification verification issues, and then that's ultimately leading to your PayPal being closed. So avoid logging in into PayPal using different devices within 24 hours. That is another consideration. If you have a personal account, we have personal and business PayPals. So if you have a personal account, avoid being sent large amounts of money by persons to your PayPal. For example, if you're being paid by a company, that's just good. But if you're being paid by your friend, maybe in another country or in the same country, it's not recommended to be sent to a personal account. Maybe you can try to use a business account. And another thing, only log into PayPal after receiving a notification in your email that you have saved some money. I know that's quite petty, but you know, sometimes being paranoid is good to avoid all these problems, PayPal being limited. And lastly, I'm going to screen share on how you can remove money that's been held on hold on your PayPal, and it soon happens within 24 to 48 hours. Yeah guys, as you know, PayPal is one of the most secure methods of payment. Time somebody sends you money, it's going to be on hold until the person confirms that he or she has received the product or service that you are sending to that person. So as you can see in my PayPal, there is $9 here that is on hold. Now how do we remove this thing on hold so that the money may reflect on my PayPal and I can withdraw the money from my PayPal? So in this case, what we do, and remember to do this, you ask the sender to confirm that he or she has received the product that you are selling to him, and in this case the sender can confirm that he has received the product after 24 hours or 48 hours. Some transactions, if they take too long, the sender cannot confirm. And so I'm going to show you on how you're going to do it. This is the money that is on hold. Now you ask your sender to confirm that he or she has received the product. This is the PayPal of the sender. To confirm that the sender has received the product or service, ask the sender to click on the transaction. For our case, this specific transaction, and then scroll down to confirm receipt. Ask your sender to click on confirm. Have you received this order? Confirm that I've received the order. So confirm you have received your order and you're satisfied with it. Click on confirm.
Now, if we log into my PayPal, now if we log into my PayPal, you can see the funds has reflected almost immediately in my account. Now, the issue is if you wait for a longer period of time, more than 24 hours, the confirmation button is going to be lost. For example, you can see this transaction here. The money is on hold. Thank you for confirming that you've received this order.